Andrew McCart, IFL TV in association with MTK Global. I'm here in Aberdeen. I've already discussed this in previous interviews. There's been a disappointment tonight. Again, the last time I came to watch you fight, your opponent didn't show up, but there was something wrong with your opponent, so I've still not seen you fight.
Yeah, my opponent didn't have the right MRI scan.
Yes. There was two scans you needed, is that right?
Yeah. MRI and MRA. Right. You just didn't have one of them.
I don't think I've introduced you yet. Chris Fraser,
yes.
The Commonwealth champion, bantamweight Commonwealth champion.
That's it. Got the belt.
You got the belt
there. Uh huh. Look.
There we go, eh? Another Scottish Commonwealth champion, just what we need. Sorry, you're saying sorry, yes. Your opponent, last time I came and watched you, you didn't fight. This time, there's another problem, which is, if you want to explain.
So there was a problem with the ambulance. Obviously, we all sign up for the British Boxing Board of Control set of rules and regulations, which dictates there has to be an ambulance present. There was a problem with the ambulance completely out with everyone's control. Everyone tried their very best to get the show to go ahead, but there was nothing anyone could do.
Yeah.
So disappointing, but it's there to safeguard everyone. So
that's it. I was at a show in Glasgow, and the third fight somebody got hurt, the ambulance disappeared, and the fight after that fight couldn't go on until the ambulance came back from the hospital. Yeah. So it was a long for an hour and a half. So the British Boxing Board of Control rules state that there needs to be two paramedics and an ambulance on site. So unfortunately, it's out of your control. But anyway, you've got that Commonwealth title.
I have.
You're still undefeated.
Still.
I've still not saw you fight.
I know.
What are you expecting for 2019 then?
2019, I'm really looking at another opportunity for a title at the end of the year. Having a maternity leave as such.
I've noticed your wife over there is pregnant.
Yeah, popping.
Yeah, she's big.
The baby's due in May,
right.
So I was hoping to get this fight, maybe one other one quite close, and then have a few months off in the middle over summer just to kind of spend some time with family, and then come back at the end of the year looking for a few fights in quick succession, potentially a title fight, but really solidify the plans for 2020. 2020 is going to be a big year.
You think by 2020, I've looked at the rankings when I was coming up here, I was looking at the rankings, I think you're ranked 14 in the world.
Yeah.
According to BoxRec anyway, so again, a couple of other good wins under your belt, under the Commonwealth belt, a couple of good wins under your belt, you could potentially be in the top 10 and maybe fighting for that world title, is that a possibility?
Yeah, 100%. I fully intend to keep myself in the gym. Mm-hmm. I don't really do totally off radar. I like to work out. I like to keep fit. So I'm always there for opportunities. Something comes knocking, then I'll be ready.
Again, is there any world champion out there that you would like to face? I've noticed that every world champion in the division has got a loss on their record, so they are beatable.
They are beatable.
Have you noticed that?
I have. I've been having a wee skim of late.
Right. Is there anyone in particular that you want your eye on? Anyone in world champion? I know there's. I don't know, but I know there's Southern American fighters, the ladies that fight in your division.
Yeah, so, kind of the lighter weights are dominated quite heavily by South American fighters, so definitely looking. Looking at that division, but we've not kind of went. The belts do kind of change about often enough. So I think it's so far in the future that I wouldn't like to go, I want you, and then that changes, and I'm like, oh no, where's it gone?
Do you think you can bring one of them champions to Aberdeen?
100%, 100%. We had a phenomenal turnout for the Commonwealth, and we opened up the room, had big screens up, cameras around the ring, and we had a great show of it. So the crowds are here for it, the funding's here for it, so there's absolutely no reason why we can't bring one of those big fights to Aberdeen.
Do you think? Josh Taylor's going to hopefully be a world champion this year.
Hopefully, yeah.
There is some good fighters in, but there's nobody quite at world title level yet under Josh. Do you think you might be that? that person under Josh, you might be the second world champion in Scotland.
That would be nice. That would be nice. I think Josh Taylor's absolutely flying at the moment. And I really hope he gets his world titles. But, you know, just to get out there a bit more and get out down in Glasgow, and I'm definitely noticing, you know, there's a bit more attention building, and I'm getting a lot of good support behind me. So if you get, you know, similar support to what Josh Taylor's getting and similar momentum, then it's, you know, it's fantastic, because that's really what brings the big fights. And, you know, you've got the World Boxing Series coming back to Glasgow, and that was at the last one. That was fantastic, absolutely fantastic.
Then you fight an undercard for Josh?
I'd love to, yeah. This next one's unfortunately too close to...
Because
I was like, ooh, no.
Well, you never know, it could be two world title fights in a show in the future. Like, you know, I mean, the Scottish fans are screaming for this, I believe.
Yeah.
Like, I travel up and down the country to, like, as many shows as I can in Scotland, and I know there's that bit where Scotland needs a world champion, need maybe multiple world champions, that's maybe where you come in and stuff like that. So the possibility of maybe you and Josh, two world champions fighting the same belt, would be absolutely fantastic.
It would be. And listen, there's nothing saying that, you know, the World Boxing Series will come back after this next time as well. And if it does, I'll be chapping on the door, being like, you know, I'm ready.
I'll put a word for you, don't mind.
Yeah, thanks. But it's... I think I've got the right team behind me. I've got the right opportunities. I'm getting the right opponents when I'm fighting. But I'm getting the right learning. I'm getting the right levels of opponents. I'm getting, you know, went for the Commonwealth. There were other things I could have went for, and it's like, I want the Commonwealth. This is, you know,
it's a lovely belt as well, isn't it?
It's really nice, isn't it? And it's always been that belt that kind of is kind of your first one, and, you know, the turning point, the big one. And it was just really important for me to have that. And I can remember watching Lee McAllister a lot of years ago win it, and think, oh my goodness, he's just won the Commonwealth.
Yeah.
And suddenly I'm standing in the ring with the Commonwealth. I was like, oh my goodness. So it's totally lost my train of thought there.
No, I was just talking about you fighting with Josh and the two world champions, but I suppose it might be stupid of me not to mention the state of women's boxing at the moment. I mean, Katie Taylor, Clarissa Shields. I mean, those two obviously carrying the flag at the moment. Would you agree with that?
Definitely. I think Chantelle Cameron is definitely one to watch. She's obviously having a wee hiatus at the moment. But there's... you know, I think she's a fantastic fighter. She's great to watch, really entertaining, heavy-handed, aggressive. Like,
you're,
I think,
just happy she's a couple of ways above you then.
A little bit, yeah. But she's good to watch. She's like, you know, fan friendly almost. And, you know, from a British perspective, I think she's, you know, slap bang up there at the top of them. And you're noticing the momentum come now, and it's just good to be at the start of that as well. Like, I know in 10 years' time it'll be different, but it's good to be at the start and to see that, and to see the same sort of women who were bringing through in the amateur at the same time, then go to the pros, and then bring through the pros at the same time. It's an exciting time for women's boxing, I think.
Well, your nickname is TFE. Would you like to just explain to people why it's TFE?
So it's the first ever, Scotland's first ever professional female boxer.
So you're the flag bearer for Scotland?
I do my best. I take my opportunities. So there was a lot of firsts when I was amateur as well, so kind of just took that forward with me and said, you know, I'm here, I'm the first, that will never be taken away from me. And I just hope that when other people look back and say, like, I was the first to do this, they're going to do better, they're going to do more, they're going to do quicker, they're going to and then have other people beat me. And that's what it's about ultimately, is you want to create some sort of legacy for someone.
Do you think that there's a possibility of, like, maybe an all-female card at one point? I'm not saying in the near future, we don't know what it's going to be like, but I mean, Katie Taylor's flying at the moment, Clarissa Shields doing her thing, she certainly talks a good game. Are you taking in that trash talking of Clarissa and maybe your next fight or something like that? You trash talk a lot?
I don't actually. I like to just quietly kind of muddle away with myself. I'm getting a bit more outspoken, but I don't know. I'm just, unless, if someone comes to me, then I'll bite back, but I let my boxer speak for itself, you know. I don't need to be on Twitter every day, try wind folk up and, you know, call people out. I'm sitting number 14 in the world after 6 fights with a Commonwealth belt. Like, folk know who I am.
Yeah.
Like, there's no need to go rubbing people up and remind them. They know who I am. If they're going to wait to take someone else from below me, they're doing it for a reason. You know, I'm here, I'm game. If they want to come get me, come get me. I'm not going to sit and waste my life on Twitter.
Well, that's actually quite a good quote. I'm here, I'm game, come get me. I like that. Well, again, I didn't get to see you fight again tonight. I'll probably have to go on YouTube and fight and look, watch your video.
We delete all that.
I suppose my next question is, are you going to cater to me next time you fight? Then you're going to come to Edinburgh and fight somewhere near me, see me coming all up to Aberdeen.
I will give you a shout next time I'm down the road.
Well, I appreciate that. Kristen, again, enjoy the new family when it comes along. And I'm looking forward to the end of this year, definitely 2020, when you bring a hotel back to Scotland.
Hope so.
Good luck with you, and I'll see you soon. Thanks, Kristen.
Thanks very much.